After your career at Blackpool, you moved back to your hometown club, Stoke, in the 60s and helped them back into the First Division. What did it mean to you to return to your hometown club?
Well, it was great to get back to Stoke City, a lot of memories, and it was a wonderful experience to play my first game. It was against Huddersfield, and we beat them 3-1. And how I got transferred was I think, for £3,500. What really happened, I had a hotel in Blackpool, and it was very inconvenient to me keep going down to Stoke every day. There was no motorways in those days, and very inconvenient to go play and train there. So what really happened that Stoke agreed with Blackpool to transfer for me for £3,500. And when I got to the ground, the manager, Tony Waddington, and the chairman was there, and he said they agreed on £3,500. I said, that's fantastic. We didn't talk about wages. And then I went to see the chairman of Blackpool, Mr. Hindley, and his director were there, and I said to them, Mr. Hindley, I said, I believe I'm being transferred to Stoke for £3,500. And they said, yes. I said, would it be possible if you let that £3,000 go on to my wages at Stoke? I'll never forget, he said, no. He says, you know, you're getting a percent out of that. And I said, how much? He says, £160. And then one of the directors, a gentleman named Mr. Marshall, got up. He says, you know, but I said, oh, Mr. Hindley, I've been here 15 years. And I said, I was supposed to be a box office for you. I didn't say I was a box. I said, and this director got up and he says, we made you. So I said, Mr. Marshall, I said, when I came here 15 years ago, you couldn't sell any season tickets. He didn't say anything. So anyway, that was it. I got transferred, and Stoke gates were going about 6,000 every week. And eventually, on the Friday before we played Huddersfield, they already sold, they already had a guaranteed gate of 35,000. Now, in a way, I had them. I could do whatever. I could have a 10-year contract. They couldn't do it. £100 a week. Easy, I could do it. But anyway, I go in, and Tony Wynn says, come on, we've got to agree terms. I said, well, you know, I was on about 35 at £40 at Blackpool. He says, well, we give you a £50 a week and a £25 appearance and a 2-year contract. I said, no. I said, what I'll do, I'll have a 12-month contract with you because things may go wrong with you. And I said, all right, I accept the £50 and £25 appearance. And then he said, oh, this 25 appearance doesn't mean to say you have 25 if you've played 3 matches. You just won once a week. So that's fine. So I just signed on for 12 months, and a friend of mine says, why did you ever do that? He says, you know, all the tickets were sold, you could have added what you. I said, well, I could not do it in my own team, my own Stoke City.
How were professional players, treated in those days by clubs? Were they used by the clubs?
They were used. I mean, today, it's such a big difference. I mean, players today, they can have a car park. In the old days, you'd have to find a space for your car. It could be 200 or 300 yards or 400. At Blackpool, you couldn't get it. At Stoke, you couldn't get it. So today, the players have a special car park and so on and so on. Such, the players today, they don't appreciate how lucky they are.
Do you think nowadays players are getting their due, or do you think it's gone too far the other way now? Do you think players in the top division are overpaid?
I think they're overpaid. Mm-hmm. I mean, you don't blame them for earning as much money as they can, but it's gone right over the top now. And I don't know if they appreciate it at all, because the whole point about it today, you, as I said, you've got the TV in your living room, you are famous overnight. You have, play one good game, you're in the England team. Now, if you want to be more famous and you can't play much on the field, hit somebody, punch somebody, go to jail, and you come out, and when you play for your own team, you get a standing ovation. That's how it's gone. Fair treatment is gone now. It's, you know, fair awards. Where is the awards these days? Everything is absolutely changed so much.
You talk about overnight fame. When you first started playing, there wasn't, yes. Well, television was a very tiny influence.
Yeah.
You wouldn't have been recognised too much, would you, compared to modern players now who can't walk down a street without getting mobbed? You presumably you could have gone around and recognised in most places.
Yeah, as I said, the TV is. I mean, you can play if the commentator he can make his star, as I said, an overnight. Well, in our day, there was no TV. I mean, if there's a little bit of a TV around. But it wasn't the matches like it is today. They put you on an hour before discussing tactics and so on. So remember that when we used to play abroad, we didn't know the players' names. They didn't know our names. You know, it was so different.
Shortly after you moved back to Stoke, you helped to take them out of the second division. Yeah. How did that feel? Was that a great moment?
That was a great moment because, you know, I played about 36 games, I think, out of 42, I was 48, because I got transferred from Blackpool to Stoke when I was 46. And, yes, I was 48 and I played those many games and things went well. And we had a wonderful team spirit. We had some excellent players. We had Jackie Moody, Dennis Violet. We had so many players. And we had a good team spirit. And we had a bit of luck, because you've got to have luck in anything. And the idea is that when you're playing, the least mistakes you're going to get in any sport, you're going to win. And we didn't make many mistakes. And when we wanted a couple of points in those days, we had a bit of luck. And that you've got to have luck in football to win championships or win cups.
You were still playing league football until you'd well turned 50.
Yes.
How tough was that on you? Was it a real struggle to keep going, or were you still...
No, it wasn't. Actually, tell you the truth, Alex, that I could have played until I was another 2 years. And I knew that, and I thought, well, 50 is a good age, and I shouldn't have. That was a very bad mistake, because I still had, I felt, quickness from the mark, because it's very important to be quick off the mark, not 100 yards, but about a 20-yard sprint, and I had that, and I still had the stamina, and I wish I'd carried on a bit longer, because in those days, they started then the new system, Alf Ransbury with the England team, midfields and so on. Well, I could have gone midfield quite easy. You didn't need to beat anybody. Then you could push the ball back anywhere. Yeah, that was a mistake.
So that's quite a tribute to your ability to keep going, because football in the mid-60s in England was quite a physical game, wasn't it? It was...
It's always physical, whatever. I mean, they talk about... Well, I'll keep repeating about going the old days, you know. I'm sorry I have to keep saying, but it was, they used to come in. They knew how to defend. I mean, I don't think the pleasant players, they don't know how to defend, because they don't tackle as the old days. I mean, we were raiders, the forwards were raiders, and the defence were defenders. They knew how to defend, they knew how to tackle. Well, there's not many defenders really can tackle, if you understand what I mean.
Mm-hmm. These days, there's a lot, talking about defence, there's a lot said these days about playing defenders who are more ball players. They talk about wing backs and using defenders as auxiliary attackers. Would you disagree with that then? Do you think defenders should be specialised stoppers rather than?
Well, no, it's just those. No, I think those days you've got to attack. That's how it is today. But remember years ago they used to put the full backs. Used to go down the wing and centre. Well, some of these full backs, of course, it wasn't their job, but that's how it used to be. And remember, you can go through any game. When you're playing, you have to have I don't know what they call them, wing or a flank, whatever. That's where all the goals come from. That's where the danger is. That's where you get more space. That's where you keep your defence and the opposite goalkeeper in trouble. He's panicky, very much so. If he gets somebody in the penalty box or down on the wing, he beats anybody, then there's trouble.